I just got done seeing an incredible performance in Times Square, and I'm here with the amazing Jordan Sparks. How exciting to perform in Times Square.
I got to do the amazing performance in Times Square. It was free, so there were tons of fans there. I'm a VH1 Save Music Foundation ambassador. It's a very long title. But it's been amazing to be able to do that and be a part of VH1 Save Music Foundation. They teamed up with the Energizer Bunny, and they are going around and giving grants to schools and helping, trying to educate people about, you know, how important music is and the positive energy that I can bring to all these kids and just being able to keep them in school, because it's kind of unfair to cut an art program. There's so many kids that, you know, want to do that, and that's what their passion is. So they can go to facebook.com and like the Energizer Bunny page, and the cool thing about that is when they like it, $1 is going to be donated to, you know, helping save the music and helping, you know, bring that in and keeping that around.
If you can learn an instrument or procure a talent,
exactly,
it keeps you focused, whether it's football or art or designing or fashion or music.
Yeah, well, and like I said earlier, you know, you have all these things. You have sports, and you have mathletes, and you have the debate club, and you have the science club, and you've got all these different things. And then for art to be cut, it's very unfair for the kids who, you know, are just like, that's what I want to do, and that's the thing that I want to go to. That's whether it's they just want an easy A or they really want to be able to discover and learn a different instrument. So for me, I'm super passionate about it because I found people that I'm still friends with and that I know I'll have a relationship with, and they taught me different things. Going on school trips, going on choir trips and competitions, you know, teaching how to, you know, lose gracefully or win gracefully.
gracefully.
Just different things like that. It's different things that you can build and learn, and it definitely builds your character, any type of extracurricular activity, and just keeping kids focused and able to do something and something to focus on and being able to just, you know, grow and finding a mentor and people that they can look up to as well.
So I'm going to take it back a minute, and we're going to talk about your dad, Philippe Sparks.
Yeah.
He was a football player with the Giants.
Mm-hmm. Go Giants.
Yes.
And the Cowboys. You started singing at 18 months,
yes.
I understand.
Yes.
Did they ever encourage you to go into a more normal career?
You know what? It wasn't until I was maybe 12 that I really kind of thought, okay, well, maybe I can actually do something with this. Because, you know, with kids and parents, like, whenever a kid does something, they're like, oh, sweetie, that's so great. So you kind of never know if they're, like, saying it because they want to make you feel good or if they really believe that you can do something. My dad was always the advocate for that, though. He was always like, my baby's going to be a star, and she's going to sing, and you should listen to her sing. And so I was singing for every family gathering, every time there were friends over. Like, that's just what I did.
You come from a biracial family. Mm-hmm. What's that like growing up in that situation?
You know what? For me, actually, I had a super normal childhood. Like, I was never teased because of it. I guess the only thing that I could say is that in school pictures, it'd be like, oh, well, there's Jordan. Like, you could always find me. I was always taller and just a little bit darker than everybody else. But I had a really good childhood.
It's kind of your gift to give back. Sometimes
exactly.
Giving is the best gift.
Yeah, for sure. And I've always loved that. I've always loved whether it's like, you know, baking a cupcake and seeing the look on my brother's face. Like, I just love seeing that joy on people's face when, you know, maybe you help somebody up or, like I said, return something and they're just like, thank you. Like, the look on somebody's face, the joy, like, it's priceless. You can't put a price on that at all.